It has its first Whole30 approved partner thanks to this woman right here, Jo Marie. She owns the Mixx, which is now launching new specialty diet menus. So I have been a fan of the Mixx since I moved here. Awesome place. But now this Whole30 menu, this is so awesome. But this is a rigorous process. What did you guys have to do to get Whole30 approved?
Well, it's very exciting. As you know, being a healthy, conscious eater, you visited the Mixx a lot. So we didn't have to make that many adjustments.
Right.
It was simply removing the wine from the Dijon mustard. So we've sourced another Dijon mustard.
Oh, okay.
We are pretty Whole30 that we have a lot of non-dairy options. Mm-hmm. We have proteins. So it kind of fit into it.
Right, and lots of gluten-free options, lots of things for allergy-conscious people. So this is one of your Whole30 recipes. What are we making today?
So Whole30 means that you don't have any sugars or nothing processed, which goes into our motto at the Mixx. And so that's
very
how we've
clean.
Always done it. Always done it. 14 years going strong, thank goodness. So how you make this soup is you'll need a little oil or chicken stock. Or if you want to go vegetarian, you could go a vegetable stock.
Okay.
And then you simply add in the, like a mirepoix, the onions minus the carrots.
Okay.
The celery here. And we have fresh ginger, always grated fresh here.
Okay.
And garlic. And so what you're going to do here is bring that till it's translucent.
Okay.
Okay. And then once it's translucent, you will add your prepped squash here.
Okay.
And the way
and what kind of squash is this?
Well, this is a butternut. This is a butternut squash right here.
Okay.
Okay. This here is an acorn squash. But you have all these squashes. These are all found at the Overland Park Farmers Market.
Oh, fantastic.
So they're always available in the fall, and that's where I'm headed next today.
Nice.
So to prep the squash, it's simply a little olive oil drizzle.
Okay.
Some salt and pepper on top. And then you have your spices, which is nutmeg, cinnamon, coriander, and all of that.
Okay.
So you'll want to bake that in the oven.
Okay.
Until, for about an hour, until it's fork tender, until it looks like this.
Oh yeah, that's beautiful.
So then, once you get your squash baked and prepped, you just set it aside. You can let it cool if you don't want your hands to get too hot. And you simply scoop out all the flesh of the squash.
Nice.
Like this. And cook it down till it's nice and combined.
Mm-hmm.
You'll want to add the rest of your vegetarian or chicken stock to it to kind of stew those vegetables. And then coconut milk is unsweetened, as you see. There's no sugar added, so you have to keep that away. So after this simmers, I know we're live TV, so don't cook it fast.
It's the magic of television.
I know. So anyway, you put the coconut milk in. You could choose to use sweetener or no sweetener. What we chose for Whole30 is dates.
Oh.
It's a natural food.
Great natural sweetener. So nice and sweet. And high in potassium, by the way, as well.
So that's how we did that.
Awesome.
So on your squashes, you have cinnamon, you have nutmeg, coriander, and clove. And then for a little acid balance, after it's simmered, you could add the lime juice in.
Okay, just a little bit of lime juice.
Just
it goes a long
juice.
Way.
Okay. And then you want to put it in a blender. So either a stand-up blender, a Cuisinart food processor. If you don't have an emulsion blender, I recommend it. It's easy. It can make salad dressings. It can make soup.
It's great for making soups.
You can even make mashed potatoes.
Oh, yeah, perfect.
You can do roasted squash mashed up.
Nice.
I know.
Oh, that sounds delicious.
So anyway, I have a picture right here, the final product. We have toasted coconut with it. Here's your spoon.
All
I used it for the squash.
All good. Hey, it's a little more squash for me then. All right, let's see.
You can put a little cilantro on top, pepitas, squash soup.
And this tastes like fall in a bowl.
Yeah.
It is so good.
Warms you up.
Yes, it is awesome. What a great flavor. The Mixx has three locations, by the way. Off 13th and Main in downtown KC, 48th and Main near the plaza, and off 119th and Row in Overland Park. They also have cafeteria.
Yes, and we actually will have this soup served today because that's where I did the test kitchen today.
Nice.
If you want to try, you could get a quart pint to go.
Oh,
enjoy it in the dining room. It's
it
fantastic.
It is so good. The weather may